Welcome back to the Real World Audio channel, and last week I have introduced to you the audio underworld Voices from the Fringe, so that there is more to audio than what is covered by the reviews and what is mentioned by the magazines. A significant portion of the audiophile experience is gleaned from the builders, from us, from you, those people who build their own equipment, modify it seriously to an extreme extent. And if you are new to audio, then you would be surprised that this is a huge segment of audio. A lot of audiophiles are into this, and it's not just a niche, it's not something that you do out of necessity. Although I would say almost everyone, including me, went into building our own stuff because we couldn't afford to buy high quality, expensive equipment. But it's more than just a way to save money. It is really the road to audio fulfillment. So all of my buddies who decided to build their own gear, they had a very fulfilling experience. Every single one of them has currently an audio system that they enjoy to its fullest degree. And those who did not go in that path, they had a much harder time. And so that's why following up on the audiophile underworld, I'm here to give you continuing audiophile education credits online. And it's not just about the underworld of audio, but in general. So if you are an audiophile, there are things that complete your education. So in the medical field, we have these continuing medical education credits, so that if you are a physician or a nurse, then you should continue your education even after you get your degree, because life doesn't stop. There's always something new, there's always more to learn, and to stay competent you need to stay educated. So this is what I'm what this channel is about, what I am offering to everyone. And this is just a snapshot. So if you know any of these people who is on the screen, please comment, write in the comments. He looks like Santa Claus. Is he really Santa Claus? If not, write down in the comments who he is. Just a hint, he is one of the fathers of audio. Without him, the loudspeaker industry would be standing on one leg. So he created half of the loudspeaker concept today. Who is this guy? Why am I showing you all a violinist? I'm not telling his name now. Please write in the comments if you know him. But he is not just a professional violinist. A second generation violinist, his father was a violinist too, but he is also an audiophile, and even more, he's a builder. He builds his amplifiers, speakers, turntables, and not just for himself, for his friends and buddies as well. And he is kind of a legend in audiophile circles. Have you heard of this guy, Arthur Salvatore? And have you checked out his website? What is that about? And why would an audiophile need to know about him? So if... one more. I'm missing out the big colorful picture in the middle. It says the Loftin White system. If you know what Loftin White is, please... comment. I can tell you that it's a type of circuitry, it's a type of amplifier, And it's a sort of circuitry that can yield fantastic results, fantastic sound. Yet it is that circuit which is the most elusive. You almost, I would say, I don't really know any commercial product that uses a Loftin White circuitry. Zero. But if you go a builder route, it's really hard to find a circuitry that has as much rewards as the Loftin White. So, at a given value point, I would say. So if you have a set amount of budget, you want to build an amplifier, you better consider the Loftin White. So thank you for checking in. This was Real World Audio. Bye bye.